Hello, hello, hello. This is Rupesh and you're watching CBBLR's video series on C++ STL topic. And this is std array. And this is a container like a standard vector. So you might have seen standard vector because people start using containers with vectors nowadays. But don't underestimate the power of this standard array. And you know what? When I started using STL and I saw that, okay, there is something called a standard array also, then first question came in my mind was, what is the need of this? Because we already have a C style array, right? Something like this. So integer array of file size. So what was the problem in this? Actually, there was no problem in this, but in advanced C++, we have much more than this. So watch this video till the end and you'll enjoy it, I'm sure. So the syntax is like this, standard or std array. This T is a type. So if you want to create an array of integer, then you will have to write it like this, std colon colon array, and then you have to give integer here, comma, what is the size. Let's suppose you want to create it as like 5 elements, then array name, that's it. So this is a declaration of standard array. So this is a type and this is the size, okay, t and n. If you know template, it will be very easy for you to understand this, but don't worry about if you don't know that. So I have noted down some points for you. So the first point is, std array is a container that encapsulates fixed size array. So I have explained in my previous video, yes, this is a full STL video series and this video is one of them, and you will get the link in the description field for that full list so that you can go inside that full list and watch whatever video you want. So in previous video, I talked about containers. So containers will contain the values. They are just the containers like vector, map, set, all the these things are containers. So std array is a container that encapsulates fixed size array. So what it technically means is it is an class. This array, this is a class. So it is something like this array, sorry, class, and then array, okay, and then curly braces. Here we have type, and let's suppose there is some array data member inside this, and this is your n, okay, and all the member functions will come here and so many other stuff. This is just for the understanding, and if you know template, then you will be writing template and type name and all that, and after the type name you will pass t comma n here, right, in templates. So as you saw that integer is going inside t, so this integer will get replaced with this placeholder, and this n will get replaced with this placeholder. Something like this should be happening, okay, not exactly this, but something like this. So now if you will see that std array integer 5 arr, now this is an object of this class, and internally this object contains an array, and you don't need to know about this particular array because you have all the interface to change this array, to initialize, assign, and all those stuff can be done using the member functions provided by this class, okay. So let's move forward. Array size is needed at the compile time. Yes, this is a very important point, actually that's why I have included it. If you remember, in C style array, sometime we were doing like this, integer array of n, okay, and here c in, you will get this array size. So user can give the input what should be the size of the array, okay, at runtime, not the compile time. So if you're using c in and you can take the input in n, then whatever user have given, suppose sometime user will give 5, so then array size will become 5, then sometime it can give 10, then it will become 10, but that facility is not available in this. So that's why I have included this point. Array size is needed at the compile time. So whatever this 5 is, it is actually needed. This placeholder cannot be empty at the compile time. And after that, assign by value is actually by value. This is kind of a funny, but I will answer this comment in later point of time, or let's discuss now itself. I'll just undo all these things. So we were discussing about this assigned by value is actually by value. What I mean to say is, let's suppose you have this something like this. So you have this array of file size of type integer, and let's suppose you have initialized, forget about the semicolon, with this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is also possible with this. We'll discuss all these things here. And let's suppose you want to pass this array into some function. So this is some function and you are passing this arr. Now, if you can recall the C style array, if you're passing something like this, this array, which is of C style array, then the pointer of that array would go to that function. So let's write that function here. And let's suppose you are having the array here. So this array will come here. But if it is traditional array, you will get the pointer of this array, whatever you have here. Okay, so you was actually not making any copy, you was actually passing the pointer. And there was one issue that if you want to get the size of this array, which is of this type, then it was a big problem for you. But in this, you can actually get the size of this array. If you are passing this array for now, then you can get the size of this array using arr.size function. Because this is an object and we have this size member variable, sorry, member function for this. But in case of this traditional array, this facility was actually not possible until unless you pass some another parameter which says the size of the array, what you are passing in. Or there was another way also, if you would send a traditional array with reference, then actually it won't decay. Yeah, and yeah, one more point. If you are passing the traditional array in one function and that function is received as pointer, then there is a decay that you are losing the information of the sizes and all that. Okay, you're just getting the pointer of that memory area and you lose the actual information. So this is called a decay. Okay, so this is just a side note for you. Okay then, so this assigned by value is actually assigned by value. So yeah, as I said, if you will pass this array, then here you will get the copy of this array. Okay, so whatever you will change in this function on this array would not reflect on this array. Okay, I mean this array, because you have the copy. So you might be aware of pass by value and pass by reference, pass by pointer and all that stuff. So this is actually pass by value, and this is possible using std array, not the traditional array. Okay, so let's move to the access elements. So there are five ways you can actually access the elements inside the array. So let's suppose you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements inside your array, then there is this dot at. You can just simply do something like cout and this array object dot at, and you can say, okay, give me third number. So it is a zero base index, so you will get this 4, okay, as output. And you have this traditional way of accessing the array, so you can actually do this. So cout, this operator, and then array, and this is also possible. Okay, this means you are actually copying from top. Okay, school days. So now you might be thinking that why we have an extra function when we can overload this operator. Yeah, this is overloaded operator. So you might be thinking why we have two similar things. Actually, it is not similar. First one is a bound safe. I mean, let's suppose you have this array of file size. What if you want to get sixth element or seventh element? You cannot get it, right? Because you don't have it. So this dot at will throw an exception called out of bound. Yes, we have something called out of bound exception, and this will throw that exception, but this will not throw any exception. Okay, so we have discussed this one, and now front. So as you are using array dot at here, you can use array dot front, then it will give you the first element, and if you are using back, then it will give you the last element. Okay, and this data is a very important thing. Actually, it gives the access to the underlying array. You remember I told you that there is a class which I rubbed here, it was holding an array. This dot data, I mean, if you have this array, this one, and arr dot data, if you are doing this, then it will actually return the pointer of that array. Okay, so internal array was there, and you can get the address of that array. So it's up to you whether you want to use that underlying array in some way, then actually you can do that. Okay, so we have discussed all the points. So let's go for this one. It is the declaration. So you have to give the size. I have already talked here, and you give the type. This cannot be empty. This cannot be empty. Okay, so both are mandatory, and this can be any type, like user defined data type and all the integral, float, whatever type you can actually give here, because you can store anything in the array, right? Just give the size and type. So this is kind of a declaration. This is the initialization. You have this, my array is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can use this way to initialize it. This is called initializer list. And there is another way to initialize. This is called uniform initialization. I have not given the video for this, I guess. I'm not sure, but this is a new way to actually initialize in C++. And this is called uniform initialization. So let's move to the next point. So I'll just scroll it a bit. And there you go. Assign using initializer list. Yes, this is a very important point, guys. Don't miss this. It is saying that assign using initializer list. Actually, you have declared the array like this. And then using this initializer list technique, you can actually initialize your array. And you remember, in traditional C style array, this facility was not there. What I mean to say is, this facility was not there. Integer array of size 5, and then later in second line you are initializing or assigning your array. No, you have to give this portion after this with this equal. What I mean is something like this. But here actually you can do this also. And there are so many member functions available inside this array class, and you should actually go and check that, because this is not the video about how to use it. It is about what it is. Okay, so there is one important function which is called dot fill, which is called fill. So we can use that function if you want to assign some typical value or a single value to all the elements. What I mean to say is, let's suppose you have done this, and what you want to initialize inside this array, let's suppose 10, and all the fireplaces you should have 10, then you can just simply do something like this. After this line, my array dot fill, and this is a function, you just pass 10, it will do the job. Okay, so there are so many things like this available inside this array member functions. You can sort the array just simply passing this array inside a sort algorithm that we'll talk little later in this video series, because that is a algorithm. So we have three things: container, iterator, and algorithm. So right now I'm talking about the container. We will talk about the iterator and algorithm in later point of time. So did you like the video? Don't forget to hit the like button and give the comment that what did you like about this video and what you didn't like about this video, or just simply good or bad will do the job. Okay, and after this video we'll go for std vector. So we'll talk about some internals about the vector, and it is going to be a lot of fun. So see you in the next videos. Bye bye.